cut. No one else can get close to them.
Oh, look at the ball! Oh, wow! Wow, he was so sideways over the hump there. And that surely is graphic demonstration of what you were saying, Jeremy.
So Moore leading at this point. From Ribeiro, Gordon, Pruitt, Bozell, Ray Hall. And Greg Moore really stunning everybody in IndyCars, leading on only his second IndyCar race. Of course, no surprise to those who knew the American racing scene well. He had, after all, won a record 10 Indy Lights victories. And Tracy battling for second place. Tracy having passed Emerson Fittipaldi. Look at the spin at the back there. Greg Moore, and he managed to recover it and come down the pit lane. That, for me, one of the moments of the 96 season. Incredible car control.
I feel we should nickname Greg Lucky Moore, because he definitely had some luck numerous time and time again.
Now this, for me, one of the most frightening moments of the 96 season. Anything could have happened here. He almost got airborne. Talked to him about this in Portugal the other week, and he said, man, I just had my eyes closed.
Yeah, I was right behind it.
This time the calculations worked out perfectly, and Greg Moore was able to hold off Michael Andretti right around the final 1 mile of this Milwaukee Oval to take his first ever kart series win and become the youngest ever winner at 22 years of age. A tremendous win for the Canadian. A sweet turn. Oh, Guterman run out of fuel. Mauricio Guterman runs out of fuel on the last lap. Mark Blundell leads the race, but can his car go that little bit further? Greg Moore is in second place and chasing. Blundell's car just has to go about 1 mile to make it to the checkered flag to take his first win here in Detroit. There are a few more corners to go, but Moore is now hounding him. Unbelievable stuff here in Detroit. Mark Blundell accelerates through the gears, builds up to sixth gear, up to about 180 miles an hour, down a couple of gears. He's got one more right-hander, and then the kick. He's slowed down! Mark Blundell has slowed down! He's run out of fuel! Oh, Greg Moore's gone past! It's gone wrong for the Pac West team! Greg Moore comes through to take the win! Michael Andretti is second! The Ferron is in third! Jimmy Vassar is fourth! Roberto Moreno is fifth! Montel is sixth! Brian Herter is seventh! Alcer is eighth! Ray Old Mines, Fangio 10th! Pappis 11th! And Blundell out of the points altogether!
Second place, Moore trying to go around the outside again. That little puff of smoke from the back of Zanardi's car. I think he's got a problem, but whether it will slow him down or not, that's another issue. And now Moore's going to take the lead from Jimmy Vassar.
There he goes into turn three down the inside. Greg Moore takes away the lead from Jimmy Vassar. Two laps to go this time around. Let me just tell you that Brian Herter is off the pace at the back of this pack, but here is a battle for the lead. Four cars absolutely nose to tail.
Two laps to go then, and it's Greg Moore up front. Scott Pruitt's getting involved, and the two Ganassi cars trying to work together to get past Greg Moore. It's Jimmy Vassar who's gone back in front now as we go on board with Scott Pruitt in fourth position. It looks as though it's going to come between these four. Greg Moore is in great shape though as he tries to get down the inside of Jimmy Vassar. This will be the white flag. There'll just be one more lap to go as they come round this time. Vassar with the advantage. Greg Moore is in second. Alex Zanardi is in third as they head down towards turn one. Zanardi goes to the outside. Moore goes to the inside. Zanardi trying to follow round as they're both on the edge. It's Moore who's got in front. Now has he got enough to hold on this the last 2 miles? They're heading up the back stretch into turn number three for the last time. Moore with the advantage. Now's the time for the final slipstream. Zanardi tries to close up. Vassar tries to close up. But I don't think they're going to get Moore. I think Greg Moore is going to take it. They come round to take the checkered flag. And the battle for second. But it's Moore. It's Greg Moore who wins it. Vassar and Zanardi go through.
with another man high up in the championship. Second place in the championship, Greg Moore, was not a happy man about the incident with Alex Zanardi that put him off into the wall. It was an incident when Zanardi had just come out of the pits. Greg Moore felt that Zanardi should have given him a bit more space. Zanardi felt it was just one of those things. The result at the right time. And Zanardi's developed that skill in his years of competition, his several years of competition now in the United States. And he really is driving well. They reckon, the Ganassi team reckon, that if he makes it to the end, he's only going to have just under a gallon of fuel left in that fuel tank. It is marginal, it is so close between these two now in terms of fuel mileage, making it to the end and dealing with the traffic. Art Meyer's the next one.
Oh, now that's helped Greg Moore. He's got caught in the corner and they come by this time. There'll be five laps to go.
Oh, and this is the chance for Greg Moore, surely. Moore's on the inside. Zanardi's trying to shut him down. Meyer's in the middle. He doesn't know where to go. What to do? Zanardi's still on the outside. Oh, and he's still got a slight straight line speed advantage. Moore's now going around the outside. Oh, this is great racing. Zanardi's wide. He went in too fast. He nearly lost it. And that's the battle for the lead.
Tragedy for all of us, and I can't express you how sad I feel.
There's the man himself. Great big smile on his face.
Here comes your dad.
Let's hear from him.
Bring Rick in here. Oh, the emotion of victory lane. Nothing replaces it. Father, son, Rick and Greg Moore embracing here. And Greg Moore, I guess racing can't get any more exciting than what you've showed us over the last 10 miles or so.
Oh, that was really exciting. I mean, we knew we had a good shot. But, you know, Alex was awfully quick down the straightaway. We were a bit quicker than him under braking. And that's all it was. He had a little bubble coming out of four, and he took the inside. I took the outside. I passed a couple guys that way, and, I mean, good job for the guys. We were back in 11.